And now back to Bobby Likis Car Clinic and your host, Bobby Likis.
Dan, welcome to Bobby Likis Car Clinic. Thanks for holding.
Hey, Bobby. Thanks for taking my call.
You're welcome.
We're thrilled that you're in Pensacola.
Thank you, my friend.
We can just bring our stuff up there and let you work on it.
I appreciate that.
We're looking at purchasing a Toyota Tacoma, and the price point is between 2015 and the 2016.
Mm-hmm.
And the 2016 has a new 3.5 liter. I think it has some new technology on the fuel injector system.
Mm-hmm.
And that's given a little bit better gas mileage, a little bit more horsepower. But I have a little bit of anxiety about buying the new model year,
okay,
you know, and the new motor and stuff like that. And I just wonder, what's your opinion on that? You think that 3.5 liter will be have the longevity that the 4.0 did for the Tacoma?
Let me just say this. Toyota products are fantastic. We have one customer who drives a Tundra with 460,000 miles, and the engine is quieter than my 2013 Jag with 50,000 miles on it. Of course, my car's always had a really noisy engine. It sounded like every rod's knocking and all the chains and everything else until the oil pressure builds up. Now, and it's just normal, but I don't like it. Now, having said that, your question is more about, should I buy the latest technology or stick with what I know to be good? My answer to that is, always buy the latest technology. Even if it's a brand new body, even if it's a brand new car, even if it's a brand new engine or powertrain, because we have today the smartest, the automotive industry spends more R&D money, second to the medical profession, than any other profession in the world. Billions of dollars per year. I mean, right here in the States alone, it's like $18 to $20 billion a year is spent on new technology. And the fact that we have instantaneous reporting, I mean, you know, you look at GM. GM can monitor not only you, but monitor your car and tell you, your tank is half empty. I mean, from your own living room, you can check your tire pressure. So I said all that to say that I would have no qualms or no reservations recommending the latest and greatest technology, and here's why. Not only is it designed for better gas mileage and cleaner air, which sometimes hurts gas mileage, but better mileage, mm-hmm. but also there are safety devices on the later car that didn't have, and the earlier car might not have had. An example of that is a good friend of mine, Gary Bazemore, lives in South Florida, had a Raptor, and he had the V8, and he loved it. He had 150,000 miles on it. He said, Bobby, it has been a workhorse. I want to get a new vehicle, but the new one is a V6, and I don't know if I like a V6. So we talked about this a couple times over the holidays, and he went ahead and got the V6. Now, he still has to sell himself on the V6 because it doesn't have that guttural sound that the V8 had. But so he's not 100% sold on the V6. Having said that, he's 150% sold on the technologically improvements that this 17 truck has over his whatever the other one was, 14 or 13.
Right.
So I would say to you to go for the latest and greatest technology. And as we speak, I'm waiting for the new iteration of my car to come out, because ever since I bought my car, the center stack and the navigation system is, and even trying to make a decent phone call hands-free, is so clunky. I just wish they would connect my car to Apple Play so I could just use my phone and wirelessly say, call Dan in Florida. You see where I'm going? And so
yes, sir.
I'm all for the latest and greatest technology, because I see it and I see it working, and cars are better made than they've ever been before, even if you're talking half years.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much. That's going to help me to, I mean, it's going to cost a little bit more money to go to that newer year, but it sounds like, you know, it'll be a newer body style,
yes, sir.
Newer technology.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It'll be well worth it.
And one more thing before I let you go. Here's the point. Never buy a new car in August. of that year. Because when you buy, let's say it's July 30th right now, today, of 18, mm-hmm. and we buy an 18 car. Well, 6 weeks from now, it's going to be a year old, right? Because right. the 19's mm-hmm. come out. So when you right. and that's why dealers will shed their inventory at, toward the end of the year. Of course, they got quotas they want to meet too, so they get their rebates. But that's all good. It's all good for the consumer. It's just the way the sales is structured. But I will tell you, from the standpoint of getting a new car and having a new car that is new longer, you should always get the latest body or wait 2 months. And I did that on my car. I waited, and I'm glad I did, because the 2012 of my car came, and I ordered it with a 6-speed transmission, and they came out with an 8-speed for the V6 in the next year. And darn if, and I waited because I wanted the next year, but I didn't know about the 8-speed. And darn if my V8 doesn't have an 8-speed German transmission. And I really, really am glad at that, because I get 26.7 at 79 miles an hour. Hey, Dan, got other calls. Wow. Got to go. Thank you for your kind words. Appreciate it.
Thank you for your help.
You're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Folks, I want to take this opportunity to welcome next week. This is...